Okay, so Basel 2 was released in 1999. Considering the pitfalls or the drawbacks of Basel 2, and Basel 2 basically has three pillars. First pillar is minimum capital requirement, which was same as it was in Basel 1, so that capital adequacy ratio has to be minimum 8%, and only difference is that this time they have considered market risk and operational risk along with credit risk in Basel II risk-weighted assets calculation. Okay, so what is basically market risk and operational risk? So market risk is basically, it refers to the risk which a bank is exposed to from the movement in the market of a change in price of interest rate, foreign exchange, any equity or commodity prices. So if there is a change of fluctuations, any of these, so then there is a market risk which is associated with or which a bank has exposure to. Operational risk is something which is basically a failure in operation which happens due to any human error or any system failure or anything which basically results in the failure of operation. So for an instance, a site is not accessible or there is some maintenance planned in that site and that maintenance is out of the budget, so it's not being performed. So that comes under operational risk. So anything which affects the operation of a bank will be considered an operational risk. Okay, so this was pillar one in Basel II, and the minimum 8% capital adequacy ratio is still maintained from Basel I. Pillar two was a supervisory review process. So in this, basically a regulator is empowered to check on a bank whether a bank is maintaining this minimum 8% capital adequacy ratio or not. The amount of money which has to be maintained as a part of 8% requirement is being maintained or not, and a regulator will timely inspect and audit the bank to check this. Okay, and the third is basically disclosure of and market discipline. So according to this, the bank's stakeholders or the people of or the customers of the bank or government or any shareholders can check whether the bank is maintaining this capital adequacy ratio or not. And along with this, the bank has to publish its financial statement and all leading newspapers or like publications about its balance sheet. Okay, or like what is the cash it is maintaining and what is the risk-weighted assets and what is the capital risk, market risk and operational risk calculation. Okay, so these are the three pillars of Basel II. So Basel II obviously supersedes Basel I, and it considered market risk and operational risk also along with itself. Okay, next we'll talk about Basel III.